people are dying slowly every day. The enemy's trying, attacking every way he can. We gotta fight, we gotta fight, we gotta fight. You see, in this generation, materialistics swallow the minds of these innocent children, yeah. We gotta fight, we gotta fight, we gotta fight. Oh, you see the fame and the drugs, the money, the lust, the violence, the hatred, and we must plead the blood of Jesus. Church folks are leaving cause they're so confused about these wrongfully teachings, making a bad name for all of us Christians.
So many saints are holding unforgiveness.
We got nation against nation, earthquakes and various places, people living in famine, everyone's losing patience. This is a war cry that everyone needs to hear.
Thank you, Lord. 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. 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 Lord God, restore back into her everything that she poured out in that dance, oh God. Thank you, Lord. Replenish her, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
He's so good. God, have your way in us, oh God. We love you. I love that Sister Michelle translated because I heard it. And when you said that you were so amazing, he said that I heard him myself. So I know that it was 100% spot on. So thank you for that. So I'm going to open up in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for all your love and your kindness, oh God. We thank you for everything you have done and everything that you have given. I ask that you decrease stumbling, oh God, so that you can increase, oh God, and light a fire under me that cannot be extinguished, oh God. Let your word penetrate the hearts of each and every one of your children today. Not only that they may live by it, but just apply it in their everyday life, as this is a practical teaching. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Amen. Shout out to Angie in the back, in the booth, huh? Lamar in the booth with an F. Angie, you're doing an incredible job. Don't say nobody ain't told you. Your whole TG family, you're doing a great job. Angie used to be scared. Now she come in, she handle her business. She flipping all over the camera. So good job, Ange. So my topic today is... I'm grateful to God that he gave me this because it is Valentine's Day weekend. Angie, as soon as we give you the accolades, every single time we give you the accolades, you start getting funny back there. Unconditional love! Unconditional love. I hope this message teaches you something different today. I hope. The word unconditional means not subject to any special terms or condition. Everybody talks about unconditional love, but I want to see if I could teach you something today. Unfortunately, mankind has always struggled with loving without conditions. We can't think about this. We got a condition for everything. You're on the park. I remember a little boy tried to punk Logan on the park on the swing. I'll be your friend if you let me get on the swing. Logan gave him the death stare. Like, boy, bye, I don't need no friends. But imagine, that's a condition. I will be your friend if you get off the swing and let me get on. Or how about in abusive relationships? I'll date you if you buy me this ring. Or I'll stay with you if you don't take that job. If you take that job, I'm out of here. That's a condition. And conditions make people feel trapped. It makes people feel pressured to be loved. Oh, man, if I take this job, he ain't gonna love me no more. Boy, bye. People have those type of pressures, right? But unconditional love, my friends, is much harder to do. It's the love that no matter what someone does or what there is or who they are, the other person will always say, I love you. When you are loved with no conditions, right, you will hear stuff like this, I love you no matter what comes our way. You ever been loved like that? I'm blessed at this stage in my life that I am being loved so good by my husband. Thank you, Muffin. Or how about this? Or even if I disagree with your decision, don't worry about it. I'm here to support you. That's what you want to do? Go, you parents. That's you don't want to go to college? It be killing you inside? It's okay. I done saved my whole life for this. It's all right. Please, it's no big deal. I'm going to support you. Unconditional love makes people feel supported and understood, and there's a level of compassion behind it. Am I right? So I just learned last year how to love unconditionally, honestly, and I'm still practicing it. So here's my confession. Don't judge me. Judge yourselves. Judge your friends. I'm not your friend. Don't judge me, okay? This is a confession. The only way I still love someone after they did me dirty, this is the truth, is because I believed in my mind they had mental illness. It's no joke. I'm dead serious. I literally put into my mind that they were mentally ill. That's family, friends, and my children. You did me dirt. You did dirty to me. And I know I gotta love you. You're mentally ill. And guess what? When I thought like that, I switched my mind and had compassion. You're mentally ill. You're sick. That's my confession. I don't know. I know this church loves unconditionally. You guys are wonderful. I'm trying to be where you are. I told you this. But I struggled with loving people for real unconditionally. With hair. And I literally would tell myself, they have a mental illness. Love them. Oh, that's not them. It's a mental illness. So God had to show me I was making myself believe a person was mentally ill. And I was actually lying to myself. And that wasn't real love. It wasn't real love. Real love is acceptance. When you could do dirt to me and I accepted it and I love you, that's real love, and that's hard to do. We always hear God loves us with an unconditional love. Let's keep it real. Let me get gangster on you. Let's keep it 100. Yes, God loves us with unconditional love. People want to come back and go back and forth with me. It's the unconditional love. God loves me whether I, bruh, if it's true, then that means with no conditions, then there's nothing a lost soul need in order to be saved. What's the purpose? Why we got church? God loves me. I ain't got to go to church. I don't got to pray. He loves me unconditional. Then there's no reason to even talk about hell or judgment. After all, everybody's going to heaven, right? Because he loves us unconditional. Am I right? Y'all scared to answer? She like, yeah, I don't know. Somebody want to argue with me and talking about, oh, God loves us unconditional. We all go to heaven. No, you not, you tomato head. That's not how it works. That's a kid term. Little kids don't, they say chicken head, tomato head. You gonna argue with me? That's not how it works. The word has always been interpreted wrong when it comes to God's unconditional love. He loves me no matter what. Sure he does. When we say God's, this is a teaching moment. When I say God's love is unconditional, it means that there is nothing you or we can do to make him love us more or less. That's what that means. That don't mean you. Let me get to where I'm going here. Right? Y'all know the song Reckless Love? I couldn't earn it. I don't deserve it, but still you choose. You give yourself away. God gave you free will. And what you choose to do with it is your business, but it doesn't make him love you any less. Do we get this? He's just not gonna come in your house like Satan does and wreck shop. He's not gonna just be busting in your doors like, hey, girl, I'm God, you better serve me. What fun is that? He's not that type of God. And that's not really unconditional love. He says he's not the God that's gonna force you. He'd be like, yo, behold. Let's look at Revelations chapter 3, verses 20. He say, behold. Bro, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come into him and dine with him and he with me. He's not going to bust in your door because he loves me unconditional. Are y'all following? He loves me unconditionally. It doesn't work like that. His love is kind. He's not just busting in. He must be invited. God, I want you into my life. God's unconditional love does not mean you can do what you want to him. It means you can do what you want, but you don't get to do it to him. Let's take a look at 2 Peter 3 and 9, the NIV version. The Lord is not slow in keeping his promise, as some understand slowness. Instead, he is patient with you, not wanting you to perish, but everyone to come to repentance. Listen, you can't just think God loves me, I can do what I want to do. That's not a condition, it's a requirement. You must repent first. You don't, I'm just going to come to God. He know me. Hey, boop, boop. God know me. It's no condition to loving you, but there is a requirement to being in a relationship with him. First off, just because I love you don't mean I'm going to put up with your mess. Let's think about you being in a relationship with somebody else, a male or a female. Matt could tell me all the time. I was telling these sisters earlier. This is why I love this guy. I'm very hard to shut down. This guy got it. Hey, match my tone, match my tone, match my tone. And I'm like, what? Match my tone. Don't talk. And I'll be like, oh, okay. I love it. I need somebody to tell me, hey, yo, I love you unconditionally, but you don't get to talk to me how you want to talk to me. There's a respect level. I appreciate that. He like, yeah, I'm going to straighten you when you get home. Right? You're not going to stay in a relationship with somebody who abuses you all the time. Unconditional love is patience. But there is some work you must do. And whether you do that work or not, I still love you. It's like a drug addict. You think I'm going to sit around and let you abuse me? You want to be with somebody who abuses you, who steals from you and mistreats you? I'm going to let you walk all over me. I want to steal all your money so we don't have a place to go, to live. That's unconditional love because I'm going to be with you even in the trenches. That means both of y'all ain't got nothing. Come on. There's a respect factor to the one who loves you unconditionally. I'm talking about a holy God. When you're in his presence, take your shoes off because the ground you stand on is holy. I'm talking about respect to the Holy One. You're talking about unconditional love. You got to respect him. Unconditional love and respect are two different things. Are we getting this? Okay. Thank you, Asia, for joining. Good praise dance today, too. So even if your life is in shambles, he loves you. He will show you kindness. He will still answer when you call him. It don't matter. Do you think he would forgive a murderer? Oh, yeah. Bingo! Teresa hit the nail on the head. You got to ask for it. Yeah, I love him. God loves the murderer. He loves a sinner. But you got to come to him. I'm not going to kick your doors down because I gave you free will. I gave you free will. If I come and bust the door down, I'm taking away the free will that I gave you. I'm not an Indian giver. What I give, I know what I'm doing. That's how God works. You got to ask for it. And God's love is so strong that his love allows him to forgive the murderer. That's what unconditional love looks like. Do we get that? I'm glad you joined to Tootie. I'm excited about this. I've read somewhere, God's love for you doesn't mean you have to accept somebody's abuse. I'm just saying that. You ain't gonna slap me and I'm gonna tell you I love you for 20 years and you never get it right? Listen, God love, why do you think about this? I love you so much, but I can't make you love me back. That's not how this works. So then when you make your choice at the end of the day, you choose not to love me. And when you get to my door, I said, depart from me, I never knew you. I read somewhere, I don't remember, love is used to alleviate human suffering. It's used to alleviate human suffering. God's love has no loopholes. Listen, my guy who I serve, he loved the Jews. He loved the Gentiles. He loved everybody. He loved the sinners. He ate with them. Everybody was talking about him like a dog. Yo, this guy, who does he think he is? He's eating with sinners. No, I love unconditionally, and that's what it looks like. He loved universally. Listen, he even loved and respected women, which was not even common during biblical times. We saw this in the Old Testament first. He ain't even sent his son yet. They didn't even send his son yet. The daughters of Zelophehad, their father died. They didn't have no brothers, and they wanted their father's land. Moses had to go to God and say, hey, these girls coming over here, man, and they asking for their father's land. That's not in the book. It's not in the law. You know what God said from heaven? Give it to them. He respected. That's love unconditionally. Even during those times, women weren't favored. But God loves us. It's universal. Think about this. And look, they wanted that land, and God gave it to them. God honored them. He honored women during the time when they weren't even viewed as being honorable. Let's take a look at another example about women. Mark chapter 1, verses 30 through 31, the NIV. Simon's mother-in-law was in bed with a fever, and they immediately told Jesus about him. Because when he's in town, you better go tell him. So he went to her. He don't got to go nowhere. You got up and you went to her. You took her hand. You ain't got to touch her. You did it. You went to her. You took her hand and he helped her up. The fever left and she began to wait on them. Listen, that's honorable. That's unconditional love. I don't know this lady. I'm just going to get up. Let's take a look at another example. Look at Luke chapter 7, verses 11 through 15, the NIV version. Soon afterward, Jesus went to a town called Nain, and his disciples and a large crowd went along with him. As he approached the town gate, a dead person was being carried out, the only son of his mother, and she was a widow. So this lady, this was her only son, and her husband had already died. And it says, verse 12, and a large crowd from the town was with her. When the Lord saw her, look at him. Look how sweet he is. Look at this unconditional love. His heart went out to her, and he said, don't cry. Then he went up and touched the bier. That's what it's called, the bier. They were carrying him on. And the bearer stood still, and he said, young man, I say to you, get up. The dead man sat up and began to talk, and Jesus gave him back to a lady. He gave him back to his mother. Respecting women, universal. His love was unconditional. It wasn't favorable at that time. Let's look at look at this. He cared. He had compassion. He also valued and loved children. Let's talk about this unconditional guy. Sinners, Jews, Gentiles, ladies, children, unconditional love. You don't get to treat me how you want to, though. Let's check out this story. Mark chapter 10, verses 13 to 16 in NIV. Is everybody getting this? Very good. People were bringing little children to Jesus for him to place his hands on them. Now, this is the time he walking around the city. He just doing his thing because he know his time is short. But the disciples rebuked them. In the world would you rebuke some children? Verse 14, when Jesus saw this, he was indignant. That means annoyed. He was indignant and he said to them, let the little children come to me and do not hinder them, for the kingdom of God belongs to such as these. Verse 15, truly I tell you, anyone who will not receive the kingdom of God like a little child will never enter it. And he took the children in his arms, placed his hand on them, and he blessed them. Unconditional love. Jews, Gentiles, women, men, children. We're watching this. I'm giving you live examples. Unconditional love. And the way Jesus showed and loved everyone when he was on earth is the way we should be. That means Jews, Gentiles, gays, straight, trans. I don't gotta agree with what you do. But baby, I love you because you came from the same creator as me. Judge somebody else. Don't pick me. Pick somebody else. We can love no matter what, but we don't have to accept the abuse. I don't have to accept it. And just because you choose to be that way, I don't have to be that way and accept that. But I love you. That's okay. Sometimes love looks like this. I can't take your abuse anymore. Look at the love. I gotta walk away. Love looks like that. I can't watch this no more. I can't watch you do this to yourself. I can't watch you keep cutting your wrists over and over. I can't watch you keep taking the drugs and stuff after I done gave you help. I gotta walk away. Sometimes that's what unconditional love looks like, but we forget. But baby, let me show you what else unconditional love looks like. When you get all cleaned up, when you get all fixed up and you've done your work, you ask God to repent, you ask God for repentance, baby, I'm like the prodigal son, the father. I got my arms wide open. Come on back home. Come on back home. I've been waiting for you. Not a day went by that I wasn't praying for you. That, my friends, is unconditional love at its finest. I don't care what you do. I don't got to sit and watch it, but I love you. But when you come back, bring it in. Bring it. Hey, y'all. Let's have a party. Let's cut the fattest calf of my son. He's back. Look at what God has done. I'm excited. I'm done. In my conclusion, I just wanted to make sure you have the lesson of what unconditional love is, because people think it's no special terms and no conditions. That's what the word means. But God's unconditional love means there's nothing you can do or say that'll make him love you any less or any more. That's really what it is. And today, I've taught you what the real term unconditional means. To love, I'm teaching you today. Look, I gave you examples, biblical examples. To love universally. Love men, women, men, children, Jews, Gentiles, Muslims, it don't matter. I love you. I ain't gotta agree with you to love you. That's terrible. And I have told you that there's nothing you can do to make God stop loving you. So this week, we are going on our fast. I'm gonna ask everybody to stand. We are going on our fast, but I'm gonna ask you to join me. I wanna do an unconditional love fast. I want us to love people the way God does without those conditions. Would y'all join me? I want to read a scripture. Can you join me for an unconditional fast starting tomorrow, Monday through Friday? You can add whatever you want. I have to take social media off. You have to take stuff. If it's food, if it's sugar, cut it out. If it's hindering you and making you wide, you need to cut it out. This is the fast. Everything, but I'm asking you, whatever you choose for your fast, can you join me and doing an unconditional love fast? Let me read this scripture to you. Ephesians 4:29-32. This is what I want you to remember during the fast. Do not let any unwholesome talk come out of your mouths, but only what is helpful for building others up according to their needs, that it may benefit those who listen. And do not grieve the Holy Spirit, with whom you were sealed for the day of redemption. This is, I want you to remember this week. Get rid of all bitterness, rage, and anger, brawling, and slander, along with every form of malice. Lastly, be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other just as in Christ God forgave you. And you can put the next slide up. In this fast, this is what I'm asking for this week, a fast for unconditional love. I want you to know that unconditional love is power. We are going to tap into what God is to us, and that is unconditional love. Communicate with someone, a friend, a coworker, a boss, a spouse, or a child. Please be conscious of every negative thought of the person you come in contact with. And all thoughts should be of unconditional love, no matter how crappy they act, no matter how much complaining they do, no matter how they irritate you, only respond with unconditional love. This fast will be letting go of negative thoughts, okay? This is letting go of this fast. It's the absence of judgment. It's the absence of anger this week. It's the absence of ego. I think, I want you. I let it go. This is, y'all down? This is very difficult. And I'm encourage you, I'm gonna have Anita send this out to you, this slide, to invite other people. I told my friend in Florida, she's actually gonna do it with us. She said, Thumbelina, I think that's hard. But how else are we gonna learn? God called me to teach. This week is all about unconditional love. Get rid of judgment. Anger and ego. Study your word this week. Remember that scripture I just read and watch what happens to you. You'll notice your energy level will rise. I'm telling you because I'm living in it. You'll notice your sleep habits will improve. You'll notice how you begin to treat people and you will start looking at them different. Put that scripture up again, Ange. And I want everybody to read it with me. Ephesians 4:29-32, this is our, I don't want to say assignment because you don't have to do it. You're grown. You got free will. You don't have to be, you could be mean to everybody all week. Just don't tell them you go to this church. Please. Let's read this together. Do not let any unwholesome talk come out of your mouths, but only what is helpful for building others up. Okay. No, I thought. 30. Rage and anger, slander, along with every form of malice. just as in Christ God forgave you. This is our assignment. Clap, yes. I think this, and what better week to do it when it's Valentine's Day? Unconditional love. There's no Bible study. This is your Bible study. Get rid of all bitterness. I'm not making this up. Y'all know that's the scripture. That's in the Bible. I wonder why we got it, why he put that in there, because we need it. I'm telling you, watch what happens this week. Every thought, I don't care if it's your mom. I don't care if it's your children. I don't care who it is, because they're coming to tick you off. It could be your boss. I want you to be like, let it go. Unconditional, no problem. If your boss is giving you too many tasks, no problem. I'll take care of it. Okay, I'm going to do my best. And mean it from here, not from here. Shakima said, that's, could you imagine fasting and you don't feel nothing? Could you imagine going on a fast and I'm perfect? No, you should feel, you should feel that Monday, Tuesday. By Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, you should be flying with this. The first day, Mac, don't tell me off, okay? I'm telling you, it's going to be hard. If your spouse get on your nerve, if a friend get on your nerve, if somebody want to gossip, get rid of all that anger and bitterness. No. And don't have a grudge. You can't talk about them afterwards. Unconditional love. And don't do what I did. Oh, child, please, I ain't thinking about them. They got mental illness. Don't do that. You know that girl ain't got no mental illness. You know ain't nothing wrong with that boy. You probably got mental illness talking about that. Don't do what I did, because God had to show me that was wrong. Accept who they are. You don't have to be around them. You don't have to live with them, invite them in your home, but you do have to love them. And now I gave you all biblical examples of loving universally. That means if you're a Democrat, you can't hate the Republicans this week and try to do it for the rest of your life. If you're the person who, I don't like what they said in the news, I don't like that celebrity, forgive them this week and try to do it for the rest of your life, okay? Or if you don't like that pastor because he a prosperity preacher, don't judge him. Keep that to yourself. And let me show you an easy way to do it. Turn the channel and don't watch him, but don't kick him in the back. Let it go. Get rid of every negative thought. To this week is the week of unconditional love, and we are excited about it. TG family, let's go! I'm excited. I hope you enjoyed the message today of unconditional love. And if anybody want to go ahead and start today, Shakima, that means you got to be nice to Niaja, yeah? And look at she like, yes. Okay? That means when Niaja do something wrong, and Niaja, you know how you be rolling your eyes to the back of your head? Now, if she knock you out, I can't, I wasn't there. Shakima, I'm going to call you and say, call me, Niaja, and say unconditional love. So that's it. I hope you understand what we are doing this week. And come back next week. And if you got a testimony, let us know so we can call you up. Tell us about how this unconditional fast has helped you, has helped you view a family member even better. I was at a funeral yesterday from my old church. Somebody had passed away, and they hated my guts. They hated my guts because I left the church years ago. They didn't even want to speak to me. And it was like, I said, hi, how are you? Good to see you. They're like, love you. Take care, bye, see you later. Love you, mean it. I don't have time. What did I do to you? But go on and be obedient to my Father. And it wasn't just one. It was about 6, 7 of them. I'm like, y'all like me? Wow, poor girl. Unconditional love. I still tap them on the back. How you doing? God bless you. Good to see you. Walked away. God bless you. So good to see you. I meant it. Because I missed them. I didn't see them in a while. But I didn't know you hated my guts. That's not my problem. That's your hate, not mine. It doesn't belong to me. It belongs to you. You keep that. But God bless you. Unconditional love. Bow your heads as we dismiss. Dear Heavenly Father, we love you so much. Father, I wish we had the capacity to love you the way you love us, but we are yet still in human form. Mortal to immortal, we have not become yet. But we want you to know that we love you with all our hearts, with every little capacity that we have. And we thank you so much for your unconditional love for us, that no matter where we go, what we do, what we say, wrong or right, you still are there to forgive us. Help us to remember to repent. This week, oh God, we're going to do a fast to make sure we're honoring you. We're doing a fast to try it out, to be conscious of it. But God, really, we want to change our lives starting this week. We don't just want to be conscious for a week. We want to be conscious for a lifetime. We want to be conscious to know that we want to get rid of the absence. We want to get rid of the thoughts of ego. We want to get rid of those negative thoughts in our mind about people and just love them unconditionally right where they are. God, we ask that you forgive us for all our sins, for all the times we didn't love unconditionally like you are, but we want to be more like you. We see what you do. We saw the examples you left us with your son. And today we all want to make the change, oh God. We are going to fast for unconditional love because we want to be just like you and your son so that we can transform a generation with this love. We love you. We ask that you take each and every one of us home safely. In Jesus' holy name we pray. Everybody say amen.
Amen. God bless you.